Okay, well, we're still at this beautiful golf resort. Two stages to go with the two riders who have really been amazing for Jayco-AlUla in this tour. Bling, stage win on stage three, I think it was, and almost about 3 days ago, another one. Yeah. How are you today? How's this Giro been for you?
I think coming into this Giro, it was going to be a roller coaster. We knew that from the preparation that we were able to get for this race with all the problems we had leading up to it. So, I mean, getting that stage win early on for me, for the team, was definitely a monkey off the back. And from there, we could really just focus on protecting Eddie as much as we could, as well as we could. And then, we had a lot of rainy days there in the middle, which was quite difficult. But now, looking at the weather, it's changed around a bit. But then to get that stage win with Zana a couple of days ago now, that was felt like mine was a year ago now. So we need an extra boost for this final week. And the way Eddie's been riding has just been super impressive, and the whole team as a whole. I think everyone's just stepped up to the plate in this Giro and delivered what we knew was possible, but sometimes it's not always the way you plan. And I think the team's just been amazing, and the fans, everything in this Giro has been just incredible.
Now, it's almost a rest day for you today, in that you don't have to worry about the GC or anything, but it's that steep at the end, it's not going to be much rest.
Yeah, I had a bit of a hit out with Eddie yesterday on the steep climbs, but I think today it's just about getting through just supporting Eddie as much mentally as we can. We can't do it on the bike today, so we'll try and keep him motivated and give him our best from what we can do. But for me, it's just get through and try and save the legs as much as I can for the sprint tomorrow in Rome.
And I reckon you're a big chance tomorrow, because you keep saying you're not quite there with the sprinters, but you have got your speed's very close. And as it got closer towards the end, you know, the difference the other day was nothing. Just a pedal stroke, you almost got it. So you must be a big chance tomorrow.
Yeah, I think I'm not actually getting better. The sprinters is getting slower. So, I've trained at altitude so many times. I've done camps in these sorts of mountains multiple times, so I mean, this was a bit my forte, was to be able to get through these climbs probably better than the pure sprinters, and then hopefully I have better legs than them on Sunday. But we'll have to wait and see. I think today we just focus on Eddie, getting him through as good as we can, and tomorrow we'll try and enjoy that sprint in Rome.
And Eddie, wow, it's been an amazing Giro, mate. I mean, I know you looked a little bit disappointed yesterday, but you shouldn't be, because you're up 2,000 metres, and it's been an amazing ride, and you're still fifth in the Giro.
Yeah, as I said, just like looking back on it yesterday, I think the altitude got the better of me, but at the same time, I think that's you have to take that as a positive as well. I was disappointed after yesterday, but when you look back on it and you put it in context and actually look at it from a point of view, okay, there's something I can improve on here, actually going up to altitude, training at altitude properly, and then maybe that time loss yesterday, that's something, a massive learning curve for me and the team moving forward. So as I said, if we can stop that in the next Grand Tour, I do. That's going to be a big positive out of yesterday. But obviously it's still disappointing to lose a bit of time. The guys did a super job yesterday. One big effort today. Try to hold on to this top five in GC. Obviously we came here with top 10 ambitions. But I didn't think I'd probably be in fifth place going into the last TT. So I think that's positive too. And whatever happens today, it's been a super 3 weeks for this team.
What's been impressive for us to watch has been the team performance, the way guys who aren't real climbers, like Bling, who are putting everything in to support you as well. So it's been a really special Team Jayco-AlUla performance over this whole 3 weeks.
Yeah, it's incredible. As I said, it's the first time we all raced with each other, I think. I only did two races with the team before this, and obviously coming in... was always going to be a challenge, you know, trying to put in my best performance and trying to get the guys to buy into, the work I've done over the last 6 months, there's a possibility there we can be up there with the best. And I think you just felt the belief week after week, and the guys really got on board. And I think this will show them that, all right, this is the level we're at, this is the level we can be at. And I think that's, again, super momentum moving forward for the team for the rest of the year. And as I said, it's once every rider on the team and stuff realise now, okay, this is the level we're at, these are the riders we have, this is what we can do in 3 weeks, let's carry that and see what we can do for the next 3 years.